Hey, this is Eric, and today it's Battle of the Big Boys. Hey, so today we're gonna check out the Marshall DSL100H, and we're gonna compare it to the Peavey 6505 Plus. So here's something to think about. When was the Peavey 6505 series designed? When was the Marshall DSL series designed? So the Marshall is actually a newer design than the Peavey. And to my ears, I hear that modernness coming out in the tone. Now the Marshall has four EL34 power amp tubes, and the Peavey has four 6L6 power amp tubes. Now both of these amps are primarily high gain amps. So for this video, that's what we're gonna focus on. We're gonna have one riff, but we're gonna have four sound samples. So this one riff is gonna be played in the first sound sample with the EQ set completely flat, except for the gain. The gain will be set at 1 o'clock. So in that second sound sample, we're gonna be tailoring that EQ to taste. You follow me? And we're also using the Ibanez TS-9 Tube Screamer. That's right, with the settings just like this. This is how I dig it. Now for each sound sample, we're gonna use one cabinet. We're gonna run both amp heads into the Two Notes Captor X, and we're gonna use the Fortin Green Beast 4x12 cabinet. And for the guitar, we're gonna use the Jackson DK2 Ash Body Green Glow with a Seymour Duncan JB in the bridge pickup. We'll listen to them both in a full mix, and then we'll listen to them by themselves isolated. And then we'll come back and talk about it. So here's the first sound sample, guitar straight into the amp head, all the controls set at noon, except for the gain, which is set at 1 o'clock. Here we go. And the guitars by themselves here. All right, here's that next sound sample. Now with this one, we're going to be using an Ibanez TS-9 Tube Screamer. Let's check those sound samples out now. And the guitars by themselves here. Do me a favor, let me know what you think. Peavey, Marshall, which one sat better with you? Hopefully you can hear the two amp heads definitely sound completely different. And it isn't as simple as EL34 versus 6L6, though I will say EL34s to my ears definitely have a certain characteristic in the low end. The 6L6 in the low end is just tighter. The EL34s tend to warble a little bit. They just have their own little characteristics in the low, mids, and lows. Now, you either like that or you don't. Additionally, the EL34 power section of these amps just feels awesome. When you're in a room and you're pushing air through some speakers, man, the EL34s, they just come to life. It's not like the 6L6s don't shine either. There's just a different thing that you really have to experience. The Peavey, to me, definitely sounds a little fizzier, especially when you set everything up to noon. Now, typically when I'm playing this amp head, I'll try to dial those out unless the particular track is really calling for that. And then at that point, it's kind of cool to have it. Now the Marshall to my ears just sounds a little more crisp, and it sounds a little more modern. So hey, do me a favor, will ya? give me a thumbs up, click like and subscribe to the channel, and ring that bell so you don't miss any future videos. We'll see you in the next video. So typically, I run the Ibanez just like this. Hey, right there. And you may think this is crazy, but you know, I like using the TS-9 like this. Yeah, that much gain. And if you ever get the chance to, I highly recommend it.